Somebody had to wire me some money one day, a couple weeks ago, and I have wired money before from my bank, and they charged me $25 to wire out, just like, it's so easy. It's sort of like what we do, just wire money. It's pressing a button, one button at the bank, and it goes to another bank, and they press one button, and that's wired. And then somebody sent me money, it cost me $25, it cost me $25 a cent, so they get me both ways. Yeah. And that's ridiculous. That's one of those hindrance fees and nuisance fees, the reason why people don't like banks as much.
Yeah. It's unbelievable. When I embarked on this, I really didn't know how the underpinnings of banks work. And it's on 30-year-old technology. And I think part of the things that we're seeing with banks in response to cryptocurrencies, you know, they're trying to get alternatives and doing what they're doing. They are seeing that this is like a useful technology that customers want. However, they could have done this 20 years ago. You know, the technology's existed for a long time to make this possible. They just had no impetus to do it because they're sitting on, you know, their banking license and whatever. So, there are more companies coming out that are doing cheaper transfers. Free transfers is what we're doing with Nano. We think that free thing is important. You know, if you're making something as critical as money, something that underpins basically everything, you can't have a company sitting at the helm. It has to be like an open thing. It's like open source. That's what we're doing. We're making a free tool, and anyone can connect to it and use it.
I think the thing that clicked for me when I first found out about it was just, you know, when I would send a Bitcoin transaction, it would take 60 minutes for it to show up, and then they took fees. So if I sent you one Bitcoin, you'd get 0.9995.
And it takes so long. Later. I mean, that chain is getting longer and longer. Yeah. Bitcoin was, and then Ethereum has a gas fee that makes a lot of people mad. Right. Made me mad when I saw the gas fees, and they change depending on, you know, how much business is going on at the time. So gas fees don't make me happy, and they get bigger and bigger. It seems like.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, how could a business make use of that if the fees that you're getting charged vary so greatly month to month? It's like, I can't predict that. I can't project that. So people just don't use it. It was funny. I was at a Bitcoin store one time. It was general cryptocurrency in-person trading. So I went there, gave them some Nano, and they gave me local currency. And I wondered why they had stools sitting around everywhere. I was like, why would anyone need that? And it's because those transactions take 60 minutes to settle, except when it's Nano.
You should have some pillows and blankets there. It takes you to spend the night to get your money in there.
Yeah, they're going to do like a multi-business approach, give you dinner while you're waiting.